525,000 moments, oh dear. 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year? In daylight, in sunset, in midnight, in cups of coffee, in inches, in miles, in laughter, in striving. 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year in the life? How about love?
So, how do you measure 525,600 minutes? That, by the way, if you don't know, is from one of my favorite all-time Broadway shows, Rent, which we're gonna talk about today. Yay, but we also have lots of other stitchy stuff to talk about. So, welcome, my name is Carmen. I am your Broadway stitcher coming to you on a icky, balmy, rainy, cold Saturday here in New York City. We just had the nor'easter come through, and I gotta say, I'm disappointed. Yeah, I grew up in Florida, and you know, we have hurricanes, so you have a lot of hurricane parties. So there's a lot of buildup, and oh my gosh, in the news, so much buildup. And at least here in New York City, Manhattan, we didn't have very much. I kept wanting to hear a lot of rain, but nothing. I even stayed up late last night stitching and frogging and all that fun stuff, which I'll show you in a bit. But anyways, so what did you think about that clip? Wasn't that so cool? So that is from an event that happened a couple of weeks back called Broadway Flea. I mentioned it in a previous episode. One of the things that they did is there's an organization called Sing for Hope. And they do great things, but one of the cool things that they do is that they paint pianos with certain logos. So there is a Dear Evan Hansen, You Will Be Found piano. There's also a Playbill, the organization Playbill piano, which I'll stick a picture here so you can see it. But they brought out the Playbill piano to Broadway Flea, which is really just, it's a flea market for Broadway lovers. To summarize. And the beautiful thing is that there was a guy playing there. And so, of course, theater nerds and lovers and geeks and all of us were standing right there singing along with some of our favorite songs. So let me tell you, young kids, holy crap, you guys can sing like nobody's business. I cannot sing, so you're not gonna hear me sing. Oh God, no. Maybe I'll do karaoke after a couple of drinks, but no, not right now. But anyways, oh my gosh, those were mostly young people up and coming. So hopefully we'll see them on Broadway soon, right? Yay. Reason why I wanted to talk about Rent, but the reason I wanted to spotlight it is because look what I got. A Rent Playbill. Yes. So thank you so much. Caitlin, Big Apple Stitching, if you are not watching her, go see her. She works in props for TV and movies. She's working on a super cool show right now. You should go check it out. Both her channel as well as the show. But anyways, she found this in her cleaning out something and she said, hey, you want it? And I'm like, hell yeah. Because remember I told you Rent was my first Broadway show. And people, I have proof. I have the pictures. Yay. So anyways, we're gonna talk about that. We're gonna talk about stitchy stuff. So this episode is the addendum. Oh my God. What did I tell you guys in my last episode? Did I not say that as soon as I finished taping, the next day I was going to find my X-Files cross-stitch project? And what happened? What do you think I found literally the next day? I was searching for some fabrics. I opened one of my plastic bins. There it was. Arg! But that's okay because I realized that I also forgot to show you some of my other Halloween stitching. So we're gonna get to see that. I got some stitchy haul, I got some whips, I made some decisions on stuff. Woo! All right, now let's get to it quickly, I hope, because today is Saturday. I was gonna have a sit and sew, no, a sew it Saturday was what I was gonna call it. But the theater gods said, thank you so much. You've been a wonderful person. Go to the theater. I put in for a lottery this morning for the matinee. And I didn't win, and I was like, okay, that's fine. I'll just sew all day or stitch all day. And then I got a call from TodayTix, which is the app that runs the lottery for this show. And they said, hey, someone did not claim their ticket. Do you want to go? I'm like, hell yeah. So got that notice at noon. So I went and got ready. You know, it was going to be a simple Saturday. I wasn't in a rush. So I had just finished eating breakfast. You know that. But you eat breakfast, you watch some floss tubes, and you read some stuff, you catch up on your email and all that fun junk. So at noon, I get the call, and I'm like, yes, I'm off to the show. Gotta get ready quickly because the matinee was at 2. The show was Apologia, which is playing off-Broadway. It's a roundabout theater production with Stalker Channing and Hugh Dancy. Very good. Summarize it in one sentence, the family dinner from hell. Yeah, it's a play. It's actually really good. And then I was walking around because I was already in Times Square and I said, what the hell? Let me go check to see if there's rush tickets. Lo and behold, people, 4:30 p.m. on a Saturday, I got a rush ticket for the 8 o'clock show for American Sun. Ah, I'm so excited. It's Adam Pasquale and Kerry Washington of Scandal. It's a political thriller. Ooh. So I'm thinking House of Cards. My friend saw it already. She says, not quite House of Cards. It's excellent though, so I'm so looking forward to it. And rush tickets, front row, dead center. Oh my gosh. You guys know I'm not a fan of front row. I'm a fan of front row mez. But I've been in this theater. It's in the Booth Theater, which is where Boys in the Band was last there, and it seems like the seats are pretty high compared to the stage, so we're not going to be looking up so high. Hey, $40 rush ticket, I'm all for it. I feel a little bad because there were some ladies in front of me who were buying tickets. Now they were buying 3 tickets, and they were paying regular price for orchestra seats, which was a lot more than $40. But probably should have said something, but you know, life is. But the theater has to make its money because it's not going to make its money from me because I'm going to use every discount I can find. So anyways, and I didn't even know if they had rush tickets to begin with. And three rush tickets is going to be hard to find anyways, blah, blah. So anyways, they got their tickets and rushed off. And then I said, hey, any chance you have a rush ticket left? And he said, yep, $40. Here you go. Dead center front row. Ooh, I am excited. Okay, so in between shows, so I went to that, picked up the tickets, came back home. Right now I'm quickly, hopefully, taping this, and then I'll go head back out to Times Square to go see show number 2, yay. So we went from a 0 show day to a 2 show day. Love it. I'm not gloating, people, but this is the beauty of living in New York City, is that this can happen. Last minute tickets. I know it sucks when you have to visit and you have specific days, and I totally get you. But if you do come, make sure you look for a discount code. You know, at least use a discount code. Don't pay full price, except for things like Hamilton, Dear Evan Hansen. Those, I think, are the only two that I've never seen discounts for. Wicked probably has discounts by now. They've been around forever. So anyways, okay, let's get started. Alrighty, first things first. Last episode, I showed you some of my Halloween stitchery. Here you go, yay. And I forgot a few things, so here's some more. This is a small wall hanging. It's a quilted one. Look how cute. Love, love, love it. This is another one of those Party with Patrick monthly stitch clubs. So we would get a design and then you just stitch it. And they're super quick, super fun, easy. And this one I did kind of like, it's a semi-decorative stitch, but look how cool, because on the back you can see them all. Yay. And there's my little tag with my name. And then on the front, oh, love, love, love it. Yay. And you can use any color combination on this, right? And it's super simple. Now, I think I have one more, and it's a circle one. But I haven't looked too closely in all the other stuff, so that's okay. All right, one thing I did show you last week was this Biscornu, or last episode. But I forgot to put the picture so you can see what it looks like. Glow in the dark, right? In the dark, so you can see all the white is glow in the dark. Love how it looks glowing in the dark. So here's a picture of that. And then another thing that I had made that's also glow in the dark. So I think for Halloween, any white, I'm always gonna stitch it with glow in the dark because it looks so cool. Is the other thing is this scissor fob needle keep that I made. Ah, look how cute, yay! It is two designs from the Prairie Schooler, I think it's Boo to You. If you look on my Instagram, you'll see all the details. I posted on there. But anyways, stitch this together. All that white is glow in the dark white. So here's pictures of how that looks. I just put a little bit of interface in the middle and then made some braid green, black, and orange, and then stuck it with a lobster claw clip and some scissors. Yay. So anyways, I wanted to show you those, and that's it for Halloween haul, Halloween stitchery. So let's move on. Okay, y'all, are you ready for some Broadway? Cause you know. Okay, as I mentioned, the first Broadway show I saw on Broadway was Rent. Back in, crap, forgot the year. 1998, and I have the proof. The proof is in the picture, right? Show me a picture. Loved it, had a great time. So I was doing a conference down in the Washington area, I think Maryland. My cousin lived down there, and he brought me over to the city for a one-day run of the city. So back then, his car was stick shift, and I don't drive stick shift, so the poor guy had to drive us from Maryland all the way into New York. We parked and walked around, obviously. Drive us all the way back home that same night. Oh my God, Beto! Love you. Thank you so much for bringing me to New York City. It was fantastic. I know we went by the towers. I don't have a picture though. I'm so sad about that. We went to the Soup Nazi, because remember Seinfeld was big back then. I know we went to Central Park. So funny thing, I had my camera was a disposable camera at that time. Oh my gosh. Horrible, horrible, right? So anyways, I was taking pictures and I wanted to save pictures because I wanted us to go to Bethesda Fountain in Central Park, because at that time, One Fine Day with George Clooney and Michelle Pfeiffer was really big, and I loved that movie. And I freaking A wanted to take a picture at the Bethesda Fountain. Dude, so I'm taking pictures throughout the day. We're getting towards Central Park. I think we got into Central Park. I tried to take a picture. I was out of film. Seriously, the one freaking picture I wanted to take is the one that I couldn't take. Oh well, Bethesda Fountain is still there. It's fantastic. We'll definitely go visit once we go visit Central Park, which I wanna do. We're not gonna get a good fall leaves this year, I think, because Central Park is still green, believe it or not. On October 27th, it's still green, yeah. So probably all the leaves are just gonna fall and we're gonna head into winter. So we'll take a beautiful winter scene with the snow. It'll be freezing as all get out, but it'll be beautiful. Anyways, I digress. Back to Rent. So my cousin brought us, spent the day here, saw Rent. Oh my gosh, fantastic, right? 500 Seasons of Love is actually the name of the song. It's not 525,600 minutes. It's Seasons of Love. What a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful song about, you know, just how do we measure the worth of a person? Let's measure in love at the end of the thing. If you haven't heard the song, just stop watching me. Go YouTube search and look for Seasons of Love Rent. Broadway musical, original Broadway cast, whatever you want to. Seasons of Love or 525,600 minutes, which if you don't know is how many minutes are in a year. So there is your education, because math, right? So anyways, so we came to New York City, we saw a show, and come on, it was 1997. I don't have the playbill, and I'm so bummed, right? But my friend Caitlin, yay, go Big Apple Stitching. Go watch her channel too, after you watch this one, after you watch this video. And she found, from the original Broadway show, so it was at the Niederlander, which is down on 41st Street, where Pretty Woman is playing now, so if you've seen Pretty Woman. Anyways, not original Broadway cast or OBC, because she saw it in 2006. So she saw it towards the end of the run, 2006. But it's the Rent playbill, yay! So now I have a playbill for the first musical I ever saw. Thank you so much, Caitlin. I so appreciate it. So, let me show you that was really actually there. Okay, so this is what the outside of the theater looked like. Yep. And to prove that I was actually inside, here is my pre-show picture. That's the stage, yay! And looking at the rest of the pictures of that trip, oh my gosh, wow. It was 1997, so you don't think it's that long ago, right? But look at the freaking yellow taxi. Holy my goodness. And look at that hair. Holy crud. And look at Times Square. Oh my gosh. Yeah. But look at that taxi. Oh my lord. Woo-wee. And then look. Ah, the Lion King. Yeah, the Lion King has been on forever and ever. I forget. It's been more than 20 years. We'll definitely talk about Lion King. I already have. I know when I want to do it. But anyways, this is Lion King at its original home, which is the New Amsterdam Theater. It has since moved into the Minskoff here in Times Square. Yay. All right, Rent. Let me tell you all about it. If you don't know what this show is about, where have you been, people? Seriously, stop. Go look it up. It ran... So this is loosely based on the opera Les Bohème. And it tells a story about really disenfranchised New Yorkers when HIV and AIDS was really prominent. It doesn't have a specific year, I think. The show takes place before midnight and then New Year's Eve, right before midnight, and then a year later. So let me see if it gives you a year. It's not really a year, it's very contemporary. Where does it say? Oh, it doesn't say. Okay. Anyways, so it's really, the characters are all bohemian style characters. So, you know, you've got, and it's about disenfranchised people. So you have gay people, you have transgendered people, homeless people out of work, really living La Vie Boheme, right? And many of them are HIV positive, have AIDS. And it's fantastic. I mean, come on. So really sad story about this though is Jonathan Larson, who wrote the show. There's other people that co-wrote with him, right? But he's the main guy. The show hadn't even started its first preview off Broadway. He passed away the night before the first off-Broadway preview. So he never got to see this beautiful musical, and it's such a shame. It won 4 Tonys. It won a huge number of Drama Desk Awards, which is, I would say it's like the Golden Globes. So Drama Desks, like Golden Globes, very much a precursor for the Tonys, similar to how the Golden Globes are precursors to the Oscars, right? So it won a Pulitzer Prize. It's a beautiful story. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. I'm gonna put a link here to the wiki page, so you can get a little bit more history about the story itself. They also turned it into a movie, which starred a lot of the original Broadway cast. So even when I went in 1997, a lot of the original cast had gone. So Idina Menzel, you know her from Let It Go. She sang Let It Go in the movie version of Frozen. But she also originated the role of Elphaba in Wicked. So any Wicked fans out there? And she's done a whole bunch of other stuff by now. Anthony Rapp, oh my gosh, he's fantastic. Taye Diggs, people, oh my gosh. Private Practice Taye Diggs, right? He was in it, and he and Idina Menzel were actually married. So a whole bunch of people that are just big stars now. So Rent was Idina Menzel's Broadway debut, by the way, FYI. Beautiful story about just caring for other people. I don't know, it's hard to put it in words. Go watch the movie, at least you can see what it's about. Seasons of Love is a fantastic song. You're gonna love it. Yeah, it's heart-wrenching, right? But anyways, so thank you so much. Long story short, Caitlin, thank you so much for finding this, for thinking of me, and for sharing it and giving it over to me. Coming out of the archives, Stitchy Archives, I have a few projects that I wanted to show you. The first one is not cross stitch, but it's close. This is a hardanger class that I took, so I could learn how to hardanger. And it's a lot easier. It's not hard to do. Ha ha, wow, wow, wow. Super cute. It's a little box. And you learn some basic stitches. Look, there's even cut work. Yeah, baby. Cut work city. Ha ha. So that was pretty cool. My first punch needle. Woo, there you go. This was obviously a test, and then that was our class piece. This class I took at Attic Needlework, back when they were in their original location. I think it was on McKellops Road. Is that right, McKenna? But anyways, original one, never finished it. Story of our lives, right? Start things and never finish them. But it's a stitch finish. The next piece is... Ah, Care Bears. Care Bear Stare, right? It's the birthday bear, and I put my name because I was birthday girl, and I am so impressed. This is super, super old. I'm talking somewhere in the 90s, right? When was the Care, remember the Care Bears were famous? Precious Moments were big back then, in the 90s. But I gotta say, the back of my project, look, that's the back. I know, right? Looks pretty good. Yeah. Ooh. That's the back, look at that. Pretty good stitching, pretty clean. And don't worry, there's not a stitch police, right, saying, oh, your back has to be super, super clean, but it's nice. It's like a professional thing, in my opinion. No one's gonna see the back, except for you, right? But there's a certain sense of pride in having a clean back. So let me show you another piece. Oh. Forever Friends, another 90s gorgeous thing, right? This was from a magazine, I'm sure. And look at this, what the hell? Did I not know that you need to have some sort of border space for framing? I don't know, whatever. Stiffest Ada I've ever seen. It literally stands up on itself almost. But again, I love the back, super clean. These dark spots are where I started and ended my threads. Look at that. So I was obviously not, well, maybe. Let me see, can I tell? Nope, I wasn't using loop method, even though this is DMC. But so cute, love it, right? Aw. And then folks, the piece de resistance, what I told you was gonna happen, happened. I found my freaking X-Files cross-stitch project. So as I mentioned last episode, I was a huge, well, I am, I'm still a fan. Sorry, papers are blowing away. I'm a big fan of the X-Files, not as much as I used to be, because it did jump the shark for me. But back in the day, and I'm looking at this, this is probably 22 count, Ada. I designed my own X-Files cross-stitch. So, I was a designer way back when, back in early 90s. So I made this piece, and I purposely left a lot of space around it because I wanted to get the actor's signatures. I have quite a few. I don't have David Duchovny or Gillian Anderson, the two leads. Someday, right? There's still time. They haven't passed away yet. But are you ready for this? Because it's pretty cool. I do have to say so myself. Ready? Da na 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 na. Ha ha ha. Now it's looking a little yellow, and that could be true, but the lighting in here sucks right now. But pretend it's white. And something, you see, very white. There you go. But look at that. Look at that. Yeah. How awesome of a logo did I make? Seriously, killed it, in my opinion. okay, so let's go through a couple of things. So I think this looks like a 22 count. So dude, this was over a one. Look at the density of those stitches, if you can tell. What I'll do is tomorrow I'll post some pictures on Instagram so you can see close-ups and stuff. And I think I used two strands on this thing because it's pretty good coverage. But anyways, the X-Files, and then I had some of the stars singing. You know, the truth is out there. Did I put anything else? Oh no, I didn't put it. Oh, the reason I put only this and I didn't put anything else. There's Deceive, Inveigle, Obfuscate. There is Trust No One. So there's a couple of other slogans. But I wanted to make sure I got the signatures first before I try to fill in, right? And then I made this. If you are a true fan of the X-Files, you know what that means. So if you do know, put it in the comments. I will give you something. I don't know what it is, but let's pick something fun. So the first person to comment and tell me what that refers to gets a prize, right? So then the next thing I did, look at this border. Kick-ass, right? And look how neat the top looks. And the reason is because look what the hell I did. I am a genius. I folded over the fabric and then I stitched through both layers. Ha! How smart was I back in the 90s? So some threads are coming loose. But check this out. Oh my God. Look how hilarious. Ugh. Come on, focus. That is a piece of yellowed tape. Oh my God. You know what? It did the job. Whatever. No one's going to see it. I had this in just a cheap plastic frame that had almost like a negative edge. So no edge at all. So that's why I could put this like this. And I did get some signatures. So here, Mark Snow, who wrote all the music. Frank Spotnitz was one of the directors or one of the producers. Mitch Pileggi was Mulder and Scully's boss. Dean Hagland was one of the lone gunmen. William B. Davis was cigarette smoking man or cancer man. AKA, okay, big spoiler here, people. Mulder's dad, right? Luke, I am your father. Mulder, I am your father. Anyways, yeah. And I told you it was gonna happen, and not 24 freaking hours later, I found that sucker. Yeah. All right, I'm over it. It's all good. Let's continue. And now we talk about haul. Because we are in October, so my haul has to be Halloween, Darktober related, right? when am I gonna stitch all this stuff? I have no idea. You know, I'm kind of a seasonal stitcher, but I think on this one project, I will stitch it out of time just because it's so cool and it's right up my alley. But I got a few things. So let's talk first. This is Creepy Crawly. Look at that. It's a coffin, people. And it opens up and there's a skeleton inside. So this is from Blue Ribbon Designs. I saw this on her Instagram feed. Completely fell in love with it, bought it right away. I mean, literally, I closed my feed, opened a browser, and went and bought it. Love, love, love it. It's one of these things where you put it together, right up my alley, like I said. It's a coffin with some matching scissor fobs, needle book, and whatnot. So I like the Here Lies because there's that sampler, Here Lies, and I think it's the one with all the ladies that were burned as witches. But I'm never gonna do that. I'm never gonna do that one. It's too big for my apartment. But that's cool because I can have a little mini fob. You know I'm gonna stitch that skeleton in glow-in-the-dark white. Boom! And I might stitch the letters here in something a little brighter than that just to make it pop a little bit better. Not glow-in-the-dark white. I think that's a little too boring, but maybe something else. So if you know of another color that's glow-in-the-dark besides green, I don't like green for this, let me know. Yeah, that would be fantastic. So as I mentioned, Blue Ribbon Designs, fantastic. Got this super fast. Like I bought it, I don't know, probably on a Friday and I had it by Monday or something like that. Super, super quick. I haven't tried it out yet. In November, I'm gonna go to Needleworker's Delight. The New Jersey Stitchers are having a meetup. So anybody who wants to go, hey, come November 17th, Saturday. And so I'll get the fabric when I'm down there. Yay. Okay, then Michelle Bendy made me do it. If Michelle Bendy gets something, people, at least go take a look to see what she's buying because you're probably gonna want it yourself. So she mentioned Wild Violet Cross Stitch. She is putting out a set of three. So she's released two and maybe the third has just come out. But she's doing a primitive stitcher tarot card set. So Michelle mentioned that someone else had stitched it on Instagram. I'll have to take a look for it too. But so far there's two. There's the stitcher and it has a needle there. And then the second one is the snipper. So we should put a Jack the Ripper or a frog here or something, right? So that one has scissors. And then there's gonna be a third one coming out. So that would be a nice set. And then of course, you know, if you're gonna be there and you're gonna buy things, you might as well buy more things. So I also got, which better have my candy? Ooh, snap. Don't mind the colors. The colors are weird. It was my printer just running out of black ink. The really nice thing of her is that she does pay as you can. So her chart is zero plus. So pay what you can. What I did is, I think I saw her video once, and she mentioned that if you do each transaction, then it takes more out of each one. So what I did is I picked one pattern and I paid $10 and then I picked three more. So I thought that was fair. You know, a couple bucks each one. Digital patterns don't go for as much as printed patterns, but I'm still trying to help because designing takes a long time, putting stuff out takes a long time, and you know, we want to help each other out. So that was Stitchy Haul. Oh, then one more thing. Sorry for the crinkle if there's crinkle. This is Lorettas Beads, and this is a Etsy store, and I'll put it on here because it's probably not going to focus. Let me see. It's out of Idaho, and she sells mini charms, all these little charms. So I got a bag of New York, and it's not going to show up, so I'll put some pictures on Instagram. Some skulls. Where's the one at? Oh, this is a to-do list. How cute is that? Some hearts. Oh, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. and some dragonfly ring thingies. Awesome store. Go check her out on Etsy. Super fast delivery. So nice. And then she sent me some freebies, some extras. Yay. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. So that's Lorettas Bead. And what I'm going to use these for, since I have all that fabric from Hawaii that I still haven't touched. Nope. Look, today was supposed to be a Sew It Saturday. It became a two-show theater day. So maybe tomorrow will be Sew It Sunday. We'll see. So I'm going to make some project bags, some kick-ass luggage tags that I saw and stuff like that. I know I owe you guys a giveaway. Thank you so much. We are past 400. We're past 425 as well. Thank you so much. So I'm going to stitch something. I'm going to sew something. And that's going to be part of the giveaway. Yay. So look for that very, very, very soon. Okay. Haul, 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 haul. And the other thing, so Blue Ribbon, the Coffin. She also included a extra chart. Hey, thank you so much. Called Established with Love. It's a cute little house. Reminds me of the monthly cottages that was Country Cottage Needlework, one of those. So I'm not gonna stitch this. So if you would like this, just say I wanna stitch the cottage. And I will pass the stash with love because I love this chart. And thank you so much, Blue Ribbon Designs. Please don't think that I'm not, I appreciate it. But I know I'm not gonna stitch it. So I don't want it to sit around in my stash. I want it to go to someone who will love it and stitch it and make us all wanna get it and buy it from you. So I wanna stitch the cottage if you would like this one. Okay, so let's go talk actual stitching. Oh, but wait, one more thing before we talk actual stitching. I organized my cross stitch people, yay. Oh, finally. And I didn't have that much physically space-wise. You've seen my little cabinet thing that I have over here on the side. But I did do a quip. I'm calling it a quip, K-W-I-P. So I took all my ready-to-stitch kits and all my whips and I put them all in zippered bags. Because people, I'm too lazy and I still haven't stitched a freaking project bag, which I will, because I see all of yours and I love them. But anyways, I put this together. I know Stitch All of the Things, you are also using the system and I love it too. So I'm doing the zippered bags with the little key tags. The difference is mine has a number. So I have a little spreadsheet. This, and I have, I don't know, a system, right? K is for kit. M is for medium because I have three sizes of bags, small, medium, large. And then the number. Yay. So I went through them all. I put them all in bags. Love, love, love it. They're semi-transparent. So I can see that this is my long dog sampler mystery. This is my Steotch along, yay, and whatnot, and I love it. Oh, and these, the reason I have these on a ring is because I just hook it onto the little knob on the cabinet, and these are the ones that I'm working on right now, so they're easy to get to. The other ones are in a plastic bin so that they're just together. Love, love, love the system. Working, easy to find. I just open my spreadsheet if I want to look for something. And there you go. Okay, let's talk stitching now. Let's talk whips and a finish. Yay, finally, right? I've been working on freaking sales this year. Year-long sales, so I'm not finishing stuff, which is so annoying. But, so let's talk that first, right? Because we want to share the finishes, share the progress. All right, look at this. Ah, isn't that cute? Love, love, love it. Yep. Oh, there we go. Yep. Ah, cute. This is Shepherd's Bush Little Pink House. The kit comes with this little tin. It comes with the fabric. It comes with the flosses. It comes with a little black button. It comes with a little cardboard insert, which I didn't use because I didn't like the size of it. So I made my own cutout. so that I could put it where I wanted it distance wise. So you see it doesn't pop up too much, but it pops up more than how they had it. Theirs was smaller and I didn't like how they had it. My OCD-ness. I do have to say this because I really like how it came out. Look at how very well rounded the finishing is. It took forever. That's why I'm so proud of it and I'm really, really happy with it. And yeah, super, super nice. In my opinion, much better than the cover picture. Because here's the cover picture. Look. I know, right? Oof. And look at mine. So yeah. And that's just part of my OCD. What I think you should do is finish it to when you are happy with it. Because you're gonna spend a lot of time. I spent like an hour just playing, futzing with the size of the cardboard I wanted, how much stuffing, how little stuffing, pulling that thing tight to get it to wrap properly. Oh, it's a pain in the butt. But anyways, here's the pattern. It's little pink house. They have a little blue house, which I thought I had bought, but I don't see it. Huh. So we'll see. Anyways, and to be honest, the main reason why I stitched this up now is because So the kit comes like this, right? Everything together with the little thing inside your normal plastic little baggie. It was really fluffy. It was thick. So it was making, it was, I put all my patterns into a binder, like a three-ring binder, and it was messing with my binder. It was making it too puffy. And so it was annoying me. And so I said, you know what? What the hell? Let me just stitch it. Quick stitch. Did this in 2 days. Stitched most of it in the first day, finished the stitching the second day, and then finished it day two. It calls for using one strand. I would have preferred, which, and the coverage is okay. Yeah, you know, it is what it is. Go look on Instagram. I have much better pictures. We're not going to play with stupid lighting. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah. So it calls for using one strand of floss, which was okay. I would have preferred two strands, but I was too far in before I really thought, okay, I really want to use two strands. There isn't enough of the green of the lawn to do two strands, but for everything else there is, which is simple. Just substitute that, right? It's an over-dyed thread. It doesn't even say what brand. So it's called Olive Branch. Oh well. Anyways. So I'm done with this, started and finished in 2 days, yay! So I am passing the stash. If you want this pattern, I'm not sending you the threads, it doesn't have the bead, it doesn't have the tin, but at least you have the pattern. And I'm sure you can find a tin in a cooking store somewhere, thrift store, Lobby Hobby, Michaels, etc. Or use something else, right? Make it your own, yay. Just say I wanna stitch the house. Not the cottage, the house. Oh, that's gonna be, okay. So let's do this. Say I wanna stitch the red cottage or the pink house. So this one is actually called Little Pink House. All right, yay, we got giveaways. Lucky you. But the next video will be really good giveaway. So watch the next video, plus this one, of course, and everything else, right? And like it, and give me a comment. All the love. Okay, next. Steotch along. Steotch? I call it cross-stitch with an attitude. Oh man, it's gonna be funny. So this is a mystery stitch along. It's only like 8 weeks, so don't worry, it's not super long. It's not super big either. It's like 85 by 115, something-ish like that. And it started 2 weeks ago. Tonight, Saturday, what day is today? The 27th? Oh shoot, I gotta go soon. Saturday the 27th is the next installment. So today after I come back from the show. But anyways, this is week one and two. And I had to grid. I'm not normally a gridder. It feels like a waste of time for me. And it's so boring, I lose interest so quickly. But the way they do it is that they give you the pattern piecemeal. For example, the first piece of the puzzle was the 69, and these guys, these little curly Q thingies. The second week was this, what looks like an eye, and these pearl drops, right? So you can see they're all over the place. So I said, you know what? No, I'm not gonna miscount and then end up having to take stuff out at the end or when it's too late. So I said, let me just grid it, get it over with. It's not that big. Super fun. It's very snarky. So if you don't like that kind of humor, don't do it. If you go to steotch.com, and I'll put the link that goes to where the videos are so you can get an idea of last year's sell. So it's very snarky, not ready for work, right? Whatever that is. I would not open these things at work. Adult, right? Not in a bad way, and things like that. Just, you know, adult humor. Okay, last one is, you've seen it before, you're gonna see it again. Right here. I think last time I just had definitely the middle part to do and get it done with. So this is the September portion and the full piece, which I'm still in love with. Oh, it's gonna be gorgeous. Is that I have made a decision. So I've been trying to stay current with it, but I started late. So this whole middle section is empty and is driving me crazy. And I'm stressing out about getting it all done on time because the next pattern releases on November 7th. And as of now, I'll show you what I have to do. I have to fill all this in and the October pieces down here. So you know what? I said, that's just too much pressure. It's not making it fun for me. So I'm just gonna reset. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fill in the stuff. Fill in the stuff, and then I'll come back and continue with the rest of this thing. It's not gonna lag because I love this thing, but sometimes I need a break. It's intense, and it's 40 count, it's navy fabric, so I can't stitch very quickly on it. I love it, don't get me wrong, love it. But remember I mentioned that, let me show you an example. That these little medallions, holy smack. This little thing, one of these, takes me 2 hours. But anyways, I absolutely love this. I will continue doing it. I'm just not going to worry that I'm not going to make it on time this time. It's just too much pressure and I'm not going to enjoy it. And you know what? This is stuff I like to do for fun, relaxation, challenge, and it's not challenging. I mean, it's too much stress. Anyways, long story short, I'm gonna stitch it at my pace. Yay. Okay, that's it for me. Oh wait, one thing. Library books, look how cool. Cross Stitch to Calm. So very cool books. They have some cool designs. They have this one in particular. Wouldn't that look gorgeous in a variegated thread? They have some geometric animals on here. So some really cute patterns, simple patterns. So I'll show you from afar. There's a seashell. It's called Cross-Stitched Calm. Stitch and De-Stress with 40 Simple Patterns. Very cool, at the library. And then this is the one that I had actually picked up first, Crochet to Calm. And the reason I picked it up was, and it's not in here, but look how cool. Oh, not that I know how to crochet. Yet I know how to knit, so I really want to learn how to crochet, but coffee mug, the reason I want to show you, and duh, I really should have put a tab on this, shouldn't I? Preparation F Carmen is this little coffee cozy thing. Ah, isn't that cute? Ah, that looks super cute. It looks like a really simple pattern, a great way to learn how to crochet, right? So I'm gonna try that out. Crochet to Calm. Ooh, so very nice pieces. Okay, I think that's it. I'm looking around. All right, folks, this will go up sometime overnight because I am off to show to Broadway. Yes, American Son, Stephen Pasquale, Adam Pasquale. Oh crap, now I think it's Stephen Pasquale. I think I misquoted last time. Kerry Washington. So look for it on Instagram. I'll let you know if it was a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Yay. All right, have a good night. Bye. Okay, the last project I worked on this week, well, in the past few weeks. If you guys saw my Instagram yesterday or Friday night, you saw that, God dang it, stupid frog, Jack the Ripper, visited me on Friday night. So I was working on this project. Yeah, that's the turn class from Noteworthy Needle that I took over at Needleworker's Delight in New Jersey. So, oh my God, I love this thing. It's so cool. It's completely up my alley. Just a fun way of finishing it. And let me show you where I'm at now. Yay. So I am now 1/12 complete. There's four sides and each side has six. So there's 24 wedges, if you want to call it, wedges that I have to make, that I have to stitch across this rolled up piece of fabric. That's two of them. So you can see, and the piece is seasons of the tree. So as you turn this piece, each piece, this is winter, fall, spring, summer, right? So I have half of summer and half of winter. I'm starting on a spring right here. Yay. And it's just gonna fill up. And the way you finish it is the magic of the piece. So anyways, Friday night, I'm getting down to here somewhere, towards the bottom of the white, and I realized I missed one stitch. I missed one stitch, people. Don't mind that. Okay, anyways, I missed one stitch. So I made the top line, one stitch too narrow. And I couldn't fudge it because the end of the line of each row is actually a 3/4 stitch. So if I try to add that extra quarter stitch, it looked horrendous. You could see that it was two different stitches rather than being one stitch. So I had to pick out everything, all that white. But anyways, you know, it was already late. So you can see when my post was, it was really late. But I couldn't go to sleep with the stupid thing still on. So I actually restitched it. And then this morning I added some pink. While watching Schitt's Creek. I'm spelling it out here because it's not the way you think I'm just saying it. It's hilarious, people. It is now on Netflix or Amazon Prime. I'll let you know up here. It's freaking hilarious. It's not wow hilarious, right? It's filmed as a drama, so a dramedy. Oh my God, these people are so clueless. It's hilarious. I love it. And it's Eugene Levy with his son Daniel, or is it the other way around? I think it's Eugene Levy and his son. They are hilarious, people. Go watch it. Yeah, it's funny. All right. And that was it for projects for this time.